All right, welcome back to the Second Opinion Loan Officer Podcast. Today we are going to cover a video content topic, cheat code. So this is a formula for creating video, for structuring video content, and actually researching the keywords, researching what you want to do the video about, and then how to structure that and how to unpack that. Now, this is the second in a series of four podcasts that I'm doing really about how to create content. So last week or the previous episodes, we talked about the three rules for video engagement, and that's where the customer is, how to get the customer, how to get more comfortable on camera so that people are attracted to you, and then how to capture and keep their attention, because these are YouTube best practices, and this is going to get you ranked higher in the algorithm. So we've talked about this part before. There's a simple and universal formula for how we're structuring all of these videos. And again, if you didn't watch the previous one where I kind of did the overview, the confidence kit episode, these are guidelines, folks. These aren't rules. What I'm sharing with you is the best way that I could explain how to put this together to give you a starting point. At some point, you're going to come up with your own structure, with your own kind of flair, your own different spin on some of this stuff. So all I'm trying to do is just give you basic training wheels so that you can dive in here, start doing this stuff with enough of a level, with a high enough level of confidence that you can produce good content, but gather that experience so that you can start to grow and become even better and better. And it's really like sports or anything. You get brilliant at the basics. You just learn the basics. You practice over and over again, and then you're going to make it your own. And that's when you're really going to shine. That's when you're going to really be able to stand out. So again, so on this particular topic, this is a universal content topic strategy. And again, it follows the same thing, follows the same rules. We're going to have an opening hook. We're going to unpack the hook. We're going to do 3 points or related questions on this particular strategy. And then we're going to close consistently with our, can I help close? So what I'm going to share with you today is one of the coolest tools that I've run across in a really long time. Now, I'm not going to dive super deep into answerthepublic.com, but I am going to show you what it does. If you're not yet a free member of the Second Opinion Loan Officer content community, I'm going to give you information on how to join at the end of this podcast, or you can find it in the descriptions. You can find it in the notes. You can find it anywhere. But I have a full tutorial on how exactly to use this tool. But right now I'm going to give you an overview of this tool, and you can use this tool for absolutely anything that you look, that you're looking for. So what Answer the Public is when you go to Google and you start typing into Google, and you know how it starts to suggest what you might be looking for, that's called the Google auto suggest, right? The auto suggest, that pops up in the search bar as you start typing and it finishes your sentence. About 40% of all Google searchers will click on that auto suggest, and that auto suggest is going to lead them to a search engine results page. And that's going to give all their answers to whatever their question is. So answerthepublic.com is a website that is a search engine for auto suggest terms. Okay. Now that sounds a little strange, but let me go ahead and show you how this works. So let me make this bigger so that you can see this a little bit. So what you're going to do is you go on to answerthepublic.com, and now this is a subscription. There's a couple of ways to get this subscription. You can either get a subscription from Answer the Public, or you can probably just use it for free. You can do 2 searches a day for free. So I think you could probably get away with doing this for free. So when you go on to answerthepublic.com, there's a big search bar there that says enter your keywords. For this particular example, I typed in VA manual underwriting. Now, what it's showing me here is if you're watching this on the podcast or if you're watching this on YouTube, I've got a screenshot of this. And again, I've got a detailed tutorial in the Second Opinion Loan Officer community that will go into this a lot more detail. But it basically, it breaks up your keywords into auto-suggested terms based on how many people are clicking on that. So the intensity of this little inner circle here is saying how many people, and then it's what type of questions, how questions, can questions, will questions, what questions. So I typed in VA manual underwriting and it gave me all of these different questions that are being asked about VA manual underwriting. Now, here's where this gets good. So once you click on one of those auto suggestions, then you're going to have the search engine result. And right at the top of the search engine results, so there may be organic and there may be paid results at the top of the search engine result, but right underneath that is a section called People Also Ask. Now, if you haven't noticed this before, this is absolutely amazing. So we have a topic called VA manual underwriting. So the auto suggestion that I click is VA manual underwriting requirement. And we're going to talk about this in a second, but that's our hook, right? VA manual underwriting requirements. And then we've got people also ask. So these are related search terms. So when we use these questions in our video and in our content, we know that we're hitting on topics, we're hitting on keywords and phrases that we know people are already typing into Google. So this is 100% a cheat code. So what you're looking for in this is you're going to use the auto suggest question or the people also ask as your opening hook of your video. So let's go back to this. VA manual. So I typed in the keywords VA manual underwriting, and then out of all of the results, I clicked on the search term VA manual underwriting requirements. Now, VA manual underwriting requirements, that's a kind of a lazy hook. That's not going to get anybody super excited. But look at what the people also ask. What is required for a VA manual underwrite? What would cause an underwriter to deny a VA loan? And can a VA loan be denied in underwriting? Those are amazing hooks, right? So I would use one of those hooks. And then when you're unpacking the video, VA manual underwriting requirements are what make the VA loan unique. Just because an underwriter told you no, that doesn't mean you don't qualify for a loan. See, you see how I kind of got that hook and then I started to unpack that hook. And all of your talking points are right here in this tool. How amazing is that? Okay, so let's go back to this. So look for the hook. The hook is either going to be the auto suggest search term, or it's going to be one of the people also ask. Then you've got seconds to capture their attention, right? So that's where you're going to use the hook, and then you're going to unpack the hook. And I just sort of did that as an example, especially around VA manual underwriting, because VA manual underwriting, if you have experience with VA, you know that VA has the most vague guidelines. They really are guidelines. They're not rules. And there's a lot of underwriter discretion in VA underwriting, especially VA manual underwriting. And so that's what you want to explain. If you're tackling that VA manual underwriting topic, which I highly recommend every loan officer does, especially if you like doing VA loans and if you like doing helping veterans, because the big call center veteran lead generation companies online do not do manual underwriting. Your Veterans United, your New Days, your Navy Federal Credit Unions, they're not going to do manual underwriting, and they're going to have overlays of minimum credit scores. So there are a ton of veterans going out and asking for second opinions because they're not having a great experience with the call center. So this is you're not alone, right? So with this particular topic of VA underwriting, listen, you're not alone, Mr. Veteran. A lot of companies, they choose not to follow the VA guidelines. The Veterans Administration is actually one of the most flexible loan tools available for any consumer trying to qualify for a mortgage to buy a house. And let me tell you why. And then you start to unpack it. And then what's the solution? You reference the guidelines. Now, for manual underwriting, if you're not addressing a specific issue, you're talking about the fact that you can do manual underwriting and what that looks like. Maybe what the credit scores are, maybe what the debt to income requirements are, maybe what would trigger a manual underwrite. If you're just doing generic manual underwriting video, that one, you're going to deliver general terms in terms of if your loan officer should be calling the regional loan center to ask questions, to get things approved, to take it to their underwriter, and they don't usually do that. But address different loan options in different ways. So whatever the solution is, you're giving generic solutions in this sense. If you're doing very specific questions, we're going to tackle that in the next video, where if you have a specific question about a specific topic, this particular strategy using the answer the public is a little bit more generic. It's a little bit more broad because you're finding the broad search terms for people. Now, you can by all means narrow this down and get pretty specific, but once you do this, you're going to talk about what the solution is, how to address it, why this problem is happening, and how you would solve this particular solution. Now, again, I feel like this is a little bit vague, but I think that's what I want you to get out of all of this is not black and white. These are guardrails. Again, I'm trying to give you broad, a kind of a broad structure from where you can kind of build a foundation so that you can start to build on this stuff and expand on this stuff. And hopefully the repetition and showing you the different scenarios and how we're doing this and why we're doing this, you can really start to structure these things and it'll start to make a little bit more sense. Now, one of the most important things that you can do when you're using generic terms like this is to make your story personal, make your video personal. So even though you're researching a generic topic like VA manual underwriting, right? Weave in personal stories related to the title and to your 3 points or to your related questions. I once helped a veteran with this or a first-time homebuyer with this. I am helping a veteran now to work through this situation on this particular issue that caused us to do manual underwriting. So you really want to personalize it. So dead air is great. It's great for a podcast, but I'm really thinking this because I know you're going to have a lot of questions, and that's okay. That's good. The more questions you have, that means you're diving into this, you're digging into this. And as you start to unpack it, you're going to have more questions. But again, let me do the overview on this. This particular strategy is a little bit more broad of a strategy. You're starting with keywords. So you're starting with student loans, down payment assistance, credit repair, mortgage credit certificates, whatever it is. You're starting with something a little bit more broad, and you're unpacking that issue so that you can relate to the customer and possibly what their experience has been up to this point and trying to get answers on this question. And then you really want to kind of weave in personal stories and talk about how you've dealt with consumers around this topic in the past, and use "I once helped and I once helped a veteran. I am currently helping a veteran. That's a really, really important part of kind of pulling all of this together. And then talk about how you applied the specific solution, unpack your experience with this guideline and how you would specifically solve this problem. So you start with a manual underwrite. Now, how do you know you have a manual underwrite? Well, it's because you don't have an AUS approval. You don't have an automated underwriting approval. So that's kind of what you talk about is, if you don't have a manual underwriting approval, here is what I do as the next step, because you don't know why they didn't get an automated underwriting approval. So what you're going to talk about is how you apply the solution, how you go through the steps to determine whether or not they're eligible for manual underwriting, or if manual underwriting is going to be a solution for them. So this is the important part. Where you're really showing them that you're an expert problem solver. You don't have to solve their problem specifically because you don't know what their problem is specifically, but you know that they have a problem if they're watching this video. So you're going to talk about how you would apply a solution or find a solution. And then finally, you want to talk about how to avoid having this problem. And this is really easy. Remember, people are watching your video because they typed in VA manual underwriting. And remember that they're most likely looking for a second opinion. You're probably not the first person that they've talked to. So educate them. How do you avoid having, if you're watching this video, and this is how I would do this slide. If you're a veteran and you're watching this video and you're concerned that this is going to be your issue and that you need manual underwriting, listen, educate yourself first, educate yourself online first, and avoid filling out those lead forms. All you really want to do is talk to a mortgage expert. Hopefully you're comfortable with me. I have a lot of experience doing this and I'm here to help. Because quite honestly, we're empowering the consumers. We're saying, if you think you have questions, talk to you, explain to your audience that loan officers have an NMLS number. Look up that NMLS number on the NMLS Consumer Access. That might give you some insight as to why you don't feel like they're delivering the kind of result that you want. And then finally, the offer to help close. So if you're a veteran and anything that I've been describing on this video today is resonating with you, if you have a very similar situation to how I helped Mr. and Mrs. Smith over here, and you have questions, I'm here to help. Contacting me is super easy. You don't have to fill out forms or an application. You can click here and schedule a time on my calendar. You can email me. Here's my phone number. You can call me. I'm happy to help. Make the barrier to reach you, to contact you, very, very low, because again, you're not trying to make them fill out an application or fill out a form. That was the experience that they had before going out and looking for a second opinion. So we know that most of these consumers that are watching our videos, we are not the first person that they searched. We're not the first person that they found. They probably went online, typed in generic terms, found a call center, filled out a form, got called by a telemarketer, and had a bad experience. So your offer to help close is a super easy, low barrier of entry. I'm here to help. If you seem like you have a situation that sounds similar to this, that's not a problem. I'm happy to help you. I'm happy to answer any questions that you have. And again, you're going to earn their business by being authentic. Your authenticity comes across when you are comfortable. So talk about things. Again, comfortable is two things. Comfortable is being comfortable on camera, which that comes with practice, but it also comes with being comfortable with your topic. So make sure you know your topic. Do your homework. Do your research. You know this. You've done this. You've helped other clients do this. Just be genuine. Just be passionate. Just show off your problem-solving skills. That's all we're doing here. See, when you're doing video folks, when you're doing this stuff, we feel like we're just talking to nobody, but remember, you're talking to one person watching this video. So it shouldn't be any different than if they were sitting across the table from you and they were asking these questions. The questions are what they typed into Google or YouTube. You don't necessarily know the question, but the fact that they're watching your video means that your answer is close to what they're looking for. And again, if they watch your video, they see that you're passionate about solving the problems. They see that you understand the problem, and they see that you've helped other people with their problems. You can earn their trust. And if you earn their trust, you will earn their business. Now, I have a good friend, Ginger Bell. We'll do an interview with her. She has a video planning guide that is just amazing. So if you need ideas for topics, I would definitely look at her book. She has a book called the it's an Edge of Marketing Video Planning Guide. It's 52 weeks of content ideas. You can go to edgeofmarketing.com to get that. I want to say it's about 15 or 20 bucks. It's definitely worth it. I would go through that book and I would take those topics and I would type in those topics as keywords into Answer the Public. And then that's where I would fill out. She has the formula there for your opening hook, for your 3 points or your related questions, and then your close. So it's a really cool little book. I'll link to her book in the community. I'll also link to it on YouTube and in the podcast if you're interested in that. Again, this is the video content cheat code. There are 4 videos in this particular series, which I'm calling the Video Creator's Confidence Kit. Once you get through these 4 videos, you should be comfortable with how to structure what to talk about, how to structure it, and 3 different ways to create content, 3 different sources to come up with content ideas on what to talk about. The one coming up is going to be the consumer direct question and answers. That's a really, really cool one that gets a lot more specific. And that's pretty fun. So if you are watching this for the first time, the reason I do this podcast is because I've been doing consumer direct content marketing for since the last crash, since 2008. And that everything that I'm sharing with you today has created a consistent source of inbound leads from consumers that have questions about qualifying for a mortgage for the last 15 years. So I'm sharing all of my best practices, and I do all of that for free in our content creator community. If you're not already a member of the content creator community, you can find it at findmywayhome.com/solo, S-O-L-O. It stands for Second Opinion Loan Officer. Once you go to that page, you're going to give us your name and your email address, and we're going to send you an invitation. It is a private community, so there are only loan officers that are content creators in there. And I give you, we post all of the videos, all of these videos from YouTube in there, all of the podcasts. We give content ideas, tips, tricks, and strategies so that you can do all of this self, all of this stuff yourself. If you're not the do-it-yourself type, I have a done-for-you solution, and that's what I do. I am the founder of findmywayhome.com, which is a consumer direct website and expert loan officer directory where consumers can find mortgage professionals that will help them answer their questions. So we have a membership platform where it accomplishes 2 things. The first thing is we're going to put you right into a stream of consumers that are asking questions now. So we're going to introduce you to consumers every single month that have questions about qualifying for a mortgage. In the meantime, we're going to help you create these videos that I'm talking about now. We've got an entire production crew. This is a completely done for you solution. We're going to ship you the equipment. We're going to help you. We're going to help give you the ideas. We're going to tell you what topics are the best topics to do content on right now. And actually, I share that for free in the community, so you don't have to be a member for that. What you do want to be a member member for is we have a the way that we do your videos. You've never seen anything like this. We're going to ship you the equipment. You're going to schedule a time with a professional director, and creating videos on the Find My Way Home Expert Network is like doing a Zoom call. You're going to talk to the director. They're going to talk you through your story. We're going to produce that into a video. We're going to transcribe it. We're going to publish it on Find My Way Home so that it gets in front of tens of thousands of unique visitors a month. Then we're going to promote that content for you. We're going to give it to you so that you can promote it. We're going to capture all your inquiries. We're going to follow up on all of the inquiries, and we're going to help you convert those. And if they're not ready to buy right now, we're going to long-term nurture those leads for you so that when they are ready to buy, they're going to know that you're the only person that they trust to help them. So if you have any questions about that, you can get more information in the description, either the podcast or the YouTube channel, or you can get more information on the Second Opinion Loan Officer community. Feel free to reach out, schedule a Calendly call if you have questions, if you want to know if this is a fit for you. If not, it's no problem. Join the community for free. Do it yourself. The done for you solution is if you really start getting serious and you start thinking about hiring people to do all this yourself, I have a solution that is significantly cheaper that's going to get you started much faster, get you much quicker results. We're going to speed up that that learning curve to less than 30 days, where you're going to start answering, you're going to start being able to give a second opinion to consumers that have questions about qualifying for a mortgage. So thanks for joining me today. The next episode is going to be consumer direct questions and answers. That is a really, really cool one. There's an unlimited amount of content out there, and it's a really, really good way. It's almost on a silver platter. So thanks for joining me. We will see you on the next episode. Again, if you have any questions, you can contact me below. If not, make it a great day, and we will see you next time.